There was a time before the internet. Well, if you wanted to send an email, you had to tie it onto a pigeon with a sat-nav. And if you wanted to attach a photo, you had to put it in the beak of a sparrow. And then tie the sparrow onto the foot of the pigeon. It was called the 70s, I think. I don't know. I wasn't there. Kick it old school like the home phone of a Roman. Build the phones just to break the phones, then they make new phones and they break those phones. We think about our phones more than we ring phones. Now all over the place like a polyphonic ringtone. When the end of the world finally thunders, we'll be watching it through the screens of our iPhone 500s, trying to get the best shot. You'll be loaning out in public for longer than you planned. Grab your phone out of your pocket and just stare into your hand. And on a train, don't look out the window, people will think you're mad. Grab your phone out of your pocket and just stare into your hand, into your hand. Stare into your hand, into your hand. Stare into your hand. We go to places to take photos of places, so people acknowledge our faces, we're in these places. When our faces were actually in these places, our faces were acknowledging the places they were faced with. Something that I'm not certain could be healthy. Before I escaped a fire, I took a swift selfie. Help me. I thought I'd look hot. In fact, I almost burnt to death. I think one day my obsession's gonna hurt me. No matter how many pages I'm refreshed, I'm still thirsty. And the fulfillment always seems to avert me. It's like a summer Friday, I'm always stuck at flipping Thursday. Wake up online and stay on it till I'm sleepy. If I could, I'd live in an HTTP. When you're alone and out in public for longer than you planned, grab your phone out of your pocket, stare into your hand. But who's in charge here? Me or my charger? Percents in the red, I feel physically lethargic. That's it guys, forget me, I've completely lost it. Go on with